I chose BPMI because it seemed like a great combination of both my interests. I was really interested in, you know, science and biology in high school, and I was also an artist, so this just seemed like the perfect fit. So I really liked the fact that it was kind of a smaller program, and I felt like I could get a lot of one-on-one experience. I would get to know my professors a little more. I think a lot of people have this misconception that it's like, okay, you can only be a medical illustrator when you graduate, but that's not true. I have a friend who's going into, she wants to be a museum curator, and she interned with the Museum of Natural History in New York last summer, so that was really cool for her. You know, I'm going into a professional program, and a lot of people decide they want to go to medical school or dental school or whatever, and you can really use this in that field. Well, I think BPMI has, it's kind of like a long specific name, and you kind of go into it thinking, well, that seems like a really specific major, you know, I don't want to get like trapped into that. But there's a lot of different career pathways. I think I'm a good example of that because I want to go into human medicine. Currently, I am taking classes to go to medical school. I'm still completing the degree, so I get to take, you know, all the fun science classes and dissection courses and illustration courses. But then it is incorporated. I take, you know, my chemistry and the biology and organic chemistry and all that fun stuff that is required for medical school. So I do plan on becoming a physician, but I think that this major is going to be a great background for me because not only have I learned more than I would just learn from, you know, general biology, I get kind of that artistic side, and I can, you know, use scientific and medical illustration as a physician. I can illustrate my own medical journals or, you know, findings, procedures, all that cool stuff, so I think it's a great benefit for me. Design 131, which is your intro drawing class, so that gives you kind of a taste of, do I like drawing, do I like this technical stuff, and then do I like biology? So you kind of get that taste as well. You put that into the, you know, first couple semesters. And then right at the start of your sophomore year, you do take your intro to scientific illustration. And that's where you do get to work with a few more scientific-based mediums. You get the more technical drawing skills in there. And I think that was probably the first taste of what it's like to actually combine the two. I get to work with the integrated studio art students, and I get to take general painting, get to learn some more design and creativity aspects of the major. I'm also in a comparative chordate anatomy class, which is really fun. We do a lot of dissections, and you get to learn a little bit about evolution and history, and, you know, history of vertebrates and mammals. I am involved with the BPMI club, so that's really active. We've taken field trips to the Mayo Clinic up in Rochester and seen their medical illustration department, which was really cool. We've gone to natural science history museums and done some sketching there. We often take trips to Chicago for the annual AMI conference, which is the Association of Medical Illustrators, to get to network a little bit with professionals in the field. So my internship was for a professor who researched plant pathology. And I worked with, she researched sudden death syndrome in soybeans. So my work for her was a disease cycle. So I got to do a series of, I think it was 6 to 8 illustrations, and then we combined those down into a, you know, a smaller progression thing that she could use in her talks. She could use it in PowerPoints for her classes or whenever she went around and, you know, presented her research to different companies. It was used in that. Dean Beekler is, I guess, the kind of main coordinator. I've had a lot of classes with him, and he's wonderful. He is a medical illustrator himself. He has his own studio, so it's great to see, you know, his business in action, as well as how he incorporates that back in with us as students. So he teaches us a lot of the business side and what it means to be an illustrator and run your own business. But then he also is a wonderful professor. He really gets to know you on that personal level, so you feel like you can go in and talk to him about, you know, this is what I want to do with my life, how am I going to get there. John Dorn is another faculty member that we have a lot of classes with, and they're both great, I think, in, you know, determining what your personal career goals are and helping you achieve those. So, you know, they get to know you in that aspect, that it's not just a professor that you have a class with and then you're done. You know, they really get to know you the entire time you're here. Jennifer Owens is my advisor, and she's been absolutely wonderful. She's also a pre-med advisor, so I kind of got lucky with both of my aspects into one, but, you know, she was really helpful when I was kind of making the transition into, I think I wanted to go into human medicine. She gave me a lot of information, and then as a BPMI advisor, she's wonderful in helping you, you know, determine what classes you have to take. For somebody that was looking into this major, I would say definitely take biology, human anatomy, if you have that offered to you. AP biology was a good indicator of kind of the levels of science you're going to be taking if AP classes are available. And definitely taking art, painting, graphic design, whatever art classes you can get your hands on, and both of those at once, you know, to see if you are interested in both those fields.